Who is the biggest rock star right now and has been for the last 7 or 8 years? Michael Jackson. In fact, MTV just had a big thing on Michael Jackson, making him the biggest artist for so many years and so forth. But what's interesting is we're not going to close just with Michael Jackson. We're going to close with Michael Jackson and the rock and roll industry as a whole and see where they're leading the world. Okay? First of all, I want to look at Michael Jackson because he goes through this whole movement. Here we see him with some ghouls or so forth from his video Thriller. But where does Michael Jackson get his songs? Could it be that he's receiving his songs from the spirit world? Somebody else is writing them, giving them to him, and he's being used as a puppet as well? Well, let's watch. This is what he says. Take his word for it. But how does he write his music? This is from the book, Michael Jackson. I wake up from dreams and go, wow, put this down on paper. The whole thing is strange. You hear the words, everything is right there in front of your face. And you say to yourself, I'm sorry, I just didn't write this. It's there already. I feel that somewhere, someplace, I feel that somewhere, someplace, it's all been done. And I'm the courier bringing it into the world. So, he believes he hears the music and writes it down. It's given to him. It's been prepared, he believes, somewhere else because it's already there when it comes to him. And he writes it down. And he believes he's just the messenger bringing it into the world. Now, musicians are very often very egotistical, okay? They don't like to give credit to their music to other people. Well, these guys are giving it back to demons and spirit guides and so forth left and right, aren't they? Okay? Because it's happening. And I'll tell you what. Michael Jackson sometimes calls these spirit guides the Force and other names. But let's look a little bit more into Michael Jackson and see what's being taught through his music and so forth. Well, why did we end up on Sgt. Pepper's Lonely Hearts Club Band? Could it be that Michael Jackson was going back just as Prince to their Satanic Majesty's request or Sgt. Pepper's Lonely Hearts Club Band? When his biggest album, the biggest album, the most popular album of all time came out, Thriller, he had worked with both Paul McCartney and he worked with Mick Jagger of the Rolling Stones. Now follow this a little bit further. Actually, on the album Thriller, guess who helped him? Paul McCartney. Okay? So before I explain too much on that, we're going to roll back and show you a video. And this is just part of the Thriller thing, and I want you guys to focus in on and see what's happening. He's going to talk about how the demons are beside you, this woman, that they want to possess you and so forth, unless you change the number on your dial. And then watch what happens. Watch closely. They're out to get you. As the demons close in on every side, they will possess you unless you change that number on your dial.
Problem.
Well, that was just all show, right? Really, he's a nice guy. Taking her away? No. Okay. Now, what if that's very telling and Michael Jackson really isn't simply the Peter Pan of pop? Okay? What if he really is a diabolical agent of Satan? What if he's in the same game? What if it's, you know, it's not like Satan is scratching his head saying, wow, I'm using all these different people, but this Michael Jackson guy popped up and he's blowing them all away. No, Satan's actually using him, as you'll see. He's already admitted inspiration from the spirit realm. But what spirit's using him? We need to test the spirits to see where they are of God. We need to prove all things, hold tight to that which is good. Who's using him? In fact, it's interesting because that Thriller video, he tells her, hey, he looks forward where he's walking with her. He says, the demons will possess you unless you change the number on your dial. And then he comes all freaked out, but then what happens? He comes all freaked out, and then he changes. Well, really, he's a nice guy, right? And then he's taking her away. He's leading her away. Then he looks at the crowd like, hey, that's not really me. I'm telling you right now, some people have got it in their head, well, he's just doing it for show. Really, he's not really, he's not, you know, an evil person and so forth. Well, that video aside, the whole concept of Thriller and the fact that Paul McCartney helped him on the album goes from the same concept of Sgt. Pepper's Lonely Hearts Club Band. Sgt. Pepper's being the biggest concept album of all time, Thriller being the biggest selling album of all time. Paul McCartney working with Michael Jackson on the Thriller album. Paul McCartney's concept, who says in Sgt. Pepper's that it was really his idea, was the same concept, to take you away. Okay? In fact, the Thriller, you saw the Sgt. Pepper's crowd and so forth, as we can look in back of us. They've been going in and out of style, the song says. But in a sense, the song remains the same because Satan is using different styles. Now, it's interesting. In the song Sergeant Pepper's, it says, "We'd like to take you home with us. We love to take you home." Kind of like magical, which it is magical, mystery tour. It is a mystery to the world, but a lot of us know what's going on. Tour, because they're touring the hearts of men. Magical mystery tours, we're hoping to take you away. You know, we're dying to take you away. It gets stronger and stronger. Where are they taking their people, though? Follow this a little bit further. Right here we see... These were the suits they used for Sergeant Pepper's Lonely Hearts Club Band, just like the Satanic Majesty Quest when we went back and forth. They all had their different suits, remember? Okay? Right here you see them in their own suits. When Michael Jackson had gone through Thriller, what did he do? He received 8 Grammys. He beat any record that had existed before for Grammys. What suit did he wear to receive those Grammys for Thriller? Right here. A Sergeant Pepper's suit. Okay? Now, those aren't everyday suits. How many of you guys have one of these at home? Okay, he knew what was going on. In fact, he's got the glove there, and sometimes he'd just be wearing one, and the other one would be off. You can go even deeper into this. You can go into Sergeant Pepper's and pull out the inside sleeve, and you see the black man holding the gloves. Okay, and it goes further and further than that. Let's move on. Well, People Magazine, message from Michael. He says, "I was sent forth for the world for the children, but have mercy, for I've been bleeding a long time now." Okay. Have mercy, I've been bleeding a long time now. But he says, "I was sent forth for the world for the children." Okay? So he believes he's a prophet. He's sent forth for the world for the children. He's being used by what? Or he's getting a message from who? Spirit entities. What we have to do is test the spirit entities, because now he's claiming to be sent forth for the world for the children, and they have the letter in People Magazine. He hadn't talked to the press for a long time. And then all of a sudden he talks to him and says, "Hey, this is what's happening. I'm sent forth for the world for the children." Well, then he writes a song and gets all these other rock stars with him called "We Are the World. We Are the Children." A prophetic statement written by Michael Jackson and Lionel Richie. Okay? Lionel Richie was blown away at how fast Michael Jackson received the music according to the book, We Are the World. In fact, it says that the lyrics in that book, you can get it at a library. It says, quote, unquote, it says the words were, quote, summoned, unquote. Okay? Let's listen to a little bit of that song, and let's critique it, and let's test it by the Word of God.
There comes a time when we heed a certain call, when the world must come together as one.
Okay, whose call is it that the world needs to come together as one at this time? It's Satan's, right? It's Satan's call for the world to unite as one. Michael Jackson says he gets his songs from where? Another realm. Who's giving him this call? The enemy. Okay? Listen, before we move on to this song, I want to let you see what Yoko Ono had a little bit to say about it. And I want you to see just some of the people that participated in this great movement to bring the world into this concept.
We are the world. Incredible. The kind of work that would bring good vibration to the world, and I think he's doing that.
Let's continue to look at this and see what spirit is behind Michael Jackson in the writing of this song.
We can't go on pretending day by day that the world somewhere will soon make a change. We all are part of God's great big family. And the truth, you know, love is all we need.
We can't go on pretending day by day that someone somewhere will soon make a change. Well, someone, Jesus Christ, somewhere on Calvary did make a change 2,000 years ago when he judged the prince of this world system and died for our sins, okay? That's who's made the change. And that someone, the Lord Jesus Christ, will somewhere in the skies, in all of his glory, will return again to make an ultimate change at the second coming of Jesus Christ. That's who we're depending upon. We are all part of God's great big family, as Tina Turner sang. She also talked about coming in touch with the universal hum. Well, the scriptures do not teach that we're all part of God's great big family. In fact, Jesus called his family little flock, okay? And he said, few will enter the straight gate. And you have to be adopted, Jesus said. You have to be born from above to enter the kingdom of God. It's a new age lie to make everybody think that you're all part of God's great family. In fact, what it does is it leaves men dead in their sins because they don't realize that they need to repent and come to the Lord Jesus Christ and put faith in him for his sacrifice and to appropriate what he's done for them on the cross. We're all, and the truth, you know, love is all we need. Is that the truth? Well, the truth, you know, Jesus said, I'm the way, I'm the truth, I'm the life. No man comes to the Father but by me. And he is love. God is love. Jesus Christ was God becoming flesh, incarnate. I'll tell you what. It says that the truth, you know, love is all we need. Where'd they get that from? The same spirits gave it to the Beatles. Love is all we need. And then they sang about love is all we need. And then they turned around and broke up and hated each other for years. Okay? You can't love without the Lord Jesus Christ. Let's move on. We are the world, we are the children. First of all, we are not the world, we are not the children. Jesus contrasted in Luke chapter, in Luke 17, the children of light with the children of the world, okay? And he said, we are the ones, and this right here says, we are the ones who make a brighter day, so let's start giving. There's a choice we're making, we're saving our own lives. Can you save your own life?
No.
Jesus said, if you save your life, you'll lose it. If you save your life and say, I'm going to run things my way, independent of God, my creator, you're going to lose your life. It's when you lose your life and you say, hey, I don't own myself. I didn't create myself. I need to serve my Redeemer. And then come to the point where you found out that you've fallen short and turn to him in faith and trust in him and what he's done for you on Calvary. That's when you have life, and that's when you'll receive your life back in Jesus Christ. In fact, it goes on to say, it's true, we make a better day, just you and me. Now they leave God out of it altogether. Let's move on. Send them your heart so they know that someone cares and their lives will be stronger and free. You can't make people free. Jesus said the truth will set you free. These are lies from beginning to end. It's very easy to detect the spirit of Antichrist through this whole song. As God has shown us by turning stones to bread. Has God turned stones to bread? That's a lie. In fact, that's a quote of Satan right out of the Bible. Because the scriptures say, Satan said, turn these stones to bread. And Jesus said, get behind me, Satan. Man shall not live by bread alone, but by every word that proceeds out of the mouth of God. It's interesting. They take and twist something from the scriptures. The very thing that Satan was trying to do, Satan was using scripture at this juncture in Christ's ministry to try to deceive Jesus. Praise the Lord. We have a great high priest, a perfect high priest who never sinned. And so we all must lend a helping hand. Well, in the same way that Satan or God did that, we should lend a helping hand. Well, God never did do that. Neither are they lending a helping hand. Watch carefully. Tell you what, you guys, we better wake up. Right here it says that if we believe, we can never fall. But it says in the scriptures in Revelation chapter 6, toward the very end, that the kings of the earth will be hiding themselves in the rocks and in the mountains, saying, how can we stand against the wrath of the Lamb? When they're bound together as one is when they're in the their most trouble, because God has his, what he's allowed to take place is culminating before his second coming. Now watch carefully. I want to show one more song by Michael Jackson, and it's called Another Part of Me. And what it's pushing is that same pantheistic idea that God is in everything, that same idea that we're all part of each other, we're all part of God's great big family, watch carefully, and that we're one, and that we need to just recognize it. And then that's out of Crowley's lie as well. And then just like Crowley taught about the stars and the age of Aquarius we saw already in the 60s, and just like the Tower of Babel, way back in Genesis chapter 10 and 11, the unity under the stars and so forth is rekindled under Babylon the great whore of Babylon in these last days through rock stars. Listen to these songs, this song very clearly, Another Part of Me. We're just waiting, they're waiting for the stars to line up and come together. This is done also at Disneyland under Captain EO. Jackson says EO means dawn. He's Captain Dawn, bringing the new age. And in Captain EO, he turns a planet of black and white, good and evil, into a paradise to make people realize that, hey, there's no real evil. We just got to have color all over the place. Watch these lyrics. Planets are lining up, bringing brighter days. The scriptures say they'll be saying peace and safety, and sudden destruction will come upon them as travail upon a woman with child, and they shall not escape. The scriptures say not that the planets will line up and bring a beautiful new age. Jesus said in Matthew chapter 24, verses 29 and 30, he said, immediately after the tribulation of those days, the sun shall be darkened, and the moon shall not give her light, and the stars shall fall from heaven, and the powers of the heaven shall be shaken. And then it says, they shall see the sign of the Son of Man in heaven. And then he said, then the tribes of the earth shall mourn. The tribes of the earth will panic. They're looking at this great big new age lie in the sky, and it's going to come tumbling down upon them as the cosmos go apart. And the Lord Jesus Christ, the creator of the universe, appears in his glory. And it says, behold, he cometh with clouds in Revelation 1:7. And every eye shall see him, and they also which pierced him. And all kindreds of the earth shall wail because of him. Even so, amen. The scriptures say that the Lord Jesus shall be revealed from heaven with his mighty angels in flaming fire, taking vengeance on all them that know not God and that obey not the gospel of Jesus Christ, who shall be punished in the presence of God and the holy angels with destruction. The Lord Jesus Christ is coming back to reign, but you don't have to be destroyed by him. In fact, you can be saved right now. The scriptures teach that the wages of sin is death. We've all sinned. The whole race is rebellious. You're just seeing the uttermost parts of this rebellion in this movement. And I'll tell you what, many people have been blinded. And I challenged many of you at the beginning as to whether these things were true or not, as to whether these things were happening or not. And I told you to be honest, to be a person of integrity. And guess what? These things are true. And I challenge you that if these things are true, that you would follow God, that you would receive the Lord Jesus Christ and choose heaven, choose life. Choose life with your Creator forever rather than eternity and damnation with a wicked and rebellious world that will be judged. We should be sorry for our sins because we have transgressed against the living God. We have totally transgressed against the living God. All of our good works, it says, are as filthy rags. We have nothing to boast in. Okay? That's why there's a death penalty on the human race. That's why you and I, our bodies are dying, because God cursed the planet because of the sin and rebellion of mankind. You can see that death through the rock music. You can see from Elvis Presley up in through the 60s with Jim Morrison, with Janis Joplin, with Jimi Hendrix, with John Lennon. You can see death throughout. Through the 70s with John Bonham of Zeppelin, and through the 80s with various different rock stars. And we can literally list hundreds of them that have died as a result of a speeded up death because of their rebellion. But you don't have to die. Because even though the Bible says the wages of sin is death, the scriptures say the gift of God is eternal life through Jesus Christ our Lord. You can have eternal life. The scriptures say, for God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whoever believeth in him should not perish, but have everlasting life. All you need to do is receive him into your life. Jesus said, except you repent, you shall all likewise perish. Repent means to turn to a 180. Instead of trusting the things in the world and following them, you follow the Lord Jesus Christ. If you don't turn, the scriptures say, you will burn. You will burn. Where are you? Are you following Jesus Christ? He that is not with me, the scriptures say, Jesus said, is against me. Are you with him or against him? No middle ground. I want to give each person an opportunity in here right now to say, hey, Joe, I agree with what you're saying. I know what's happening, and I know I need Jesus, and I know I'm not here by accident. I know that God has me here for a reason, and I want to receive him into my life. With all heads up and all eyes open, if you want to receive the Lord Jesus Christ, and you're saying, hey, I want to receive eternal life right now and follow Jesus and not spend eternity in hell, please come up here. Just come up here, and we'll pray, all of you that want to receive the Lord Jesus.